Hi, welcome to this question right here. So we're trying to figure out the angle DC and E, right? So DCE, well, we're looking for this angle right here, okay? So that angle is missing. So what do we know about the tangent property here? Well, these are tangent lines, okay? Like this point right here, this line right here is tangent. Every time you draw a tangent line to your circle, they always form a perpendicular line to the center of your circle. So that will form a 90 degrees for sure, because it's perpendicular. So that means this is 90 degrees as well. Okay? So what do we have here so far? BDC. This is DC. Actually, we don't even need the tangent line, okay? Because they tell us that there's a triangle right here. Okay? There's a triangle right here. Do you see that? The angle here is 100 degrees, and these two sides are the same length, represented by the two lines right here and the two lines right there. So what that means is, it's an isosceles triangle. So if I just kind of bring that triangle out here, it means that this is 100 degrees, and this side is the same. That means these two angles here will be identical, okay? So in a triangle, the sum of all the angles is 180, right? If you take away that 100 right now, you get 80 degrees left over. And that 80 degrees is shared equally between these two angles because this is an isosceles triangle, right? So divide that by 2, you get yourself a 40 degrees. And guess what? That is the angle that they're looking for. So the angle for this question for the DCE is just 40 degrees. All right? Thanks for watching.